Working with colors in Canva can really make your designs pop. And there's a new option available called Gradient. And I'm going to share a few ways that you can use it with your Canva designs. My name is Kat, and this is Canva Catterday. Now, Canva gives you options for adding color to your designs. You have all kinds of options available, but now we can add our own gradient colors. So I'm going to show you how to do that. I'm going to go over to the elements section and I'm just going to add a square right here. And you can see it has given that square to me in one of my brand colors. So we are going to change this now to become a gradient. You're going to go up here to the little square color box and you're going to click on these little radio buttons that are right here in your color square. And there's now a new option right here that says gradient. And when I click on that, Canva is going to create a gradient. Now it's giving me a color choice based on my main color. You can change the direction of that gradient. Right now it's linear from left to right, but I can make it horizontal. I can make it diagonal. I can change it to circular and I can make it an offset circular. So not only can you change the direction, you can also change the colors. If you don't like what they've given you, you can change it. Click on the color, and now I can just drag my slider around to pick a different shade if I want to, or a completely different color, anything that you want. You can also add your color hex codes right here. A hex code is just a 6-digit alphanumeric code that represents color when you're viewing things online. So if you happen to know your brand's hex color codes, you can put them right in here. Now, if I have multiple ways to use this gradient, I can add additional colors to this. So I can just click this plus sign and I can add another color. Maybe I want to put a little bit of a yellow in there. And then if I want to add another one, maybe I want to put a little bit of a peachy pink in there, just like that. And I can continue to add colors to this gradient. And then just like I mentioned, if you don't like it, you can change the colors, you can change the direction, basically anything that you would like to do. Now, not only can you change the direction of the colors, you can change the order in which those colors fall. So right now I've got teal is showing up on the as the first color on the left side. If I don't want it there, I can move it. I can drag it over here to the end. And now you see teal just moved over to the end. I can grab my green, bring that over here. Grab this color, bring it right here. And I've just changed the direction of that gradient. And you can do this with any of the colors that are here within the gradient set. So if we go back up here to this first example that I showed and I click on these radio buttons, you can see that I have red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and purple. If I want to rearrange those colors, maybe I want purple to be first. I just drag it. Whoops, let me go over here. I just drag that color over to the first spot. And there you go. It just moved purple into that first spot for me. It's pretty, pretty cool. So you can add gradient colors to a background, to a shape, to a frame, and to a grid. So right here, we did our shape. So if we want to do a different shape, I'm just going to go over here to elements and go to lines and shapes, click see all. And I have all of these different shapes that I can add a gradient to. So I'm just going to pick this little starburst right there. And I'm just going to use one of Canva's pre-selected colors. Down here at the bottom, Canva has given you some color combinations already for you to choose from. And there's a pretty good variety of color choices right here. So I'm just going to pick maybe that one right there. You can see it's giving me that nice little pink to like an orangey color right there. If I don't like that combination, if I want to maybe change the direction or maybe change the way the colors fall, you're just going to click on the box once again on the radio controls. And here you can see I have my two color choices. I can change the direction like that, or I can change which order they fall in like that. It's very, very cool. Now, one other thing that you can do when it comes to these color options is you can make your gradients fade to transparent. This one is really fun. Let me grab this. Let me grab a square and let's bring this up. I'm going to take this teal right here. I'm going to go into my gradient option. Now it's suggesting this color option right here. So what you're going to do now is I'm going to click on this color. See right here, it says 100%. That's telling me that that lighter color is at 100% opacity. That means you can't see through it. Well, I'm going to take this little slider bar right here and I'm going to drag it all the way to zero. And as I do it, see that number? It's changing. I'm going to drag it to zero. Now what I've done is I have now created that gradient. So I've got a color that fades to transparent background. You can see right here in the preview, it fades to a transparent. This is really cool if you want to do maybe some neat text effects and things like that. So I'm going to take this right here and bring it over here. Let me just duplicate this. And I'm going to change the direction of this second square so that my transparent is on the left and my color is on the right. There we go. See, I changed it, how the transparent's on the left side. And let me put it linear like that and change this one to linear like that. So you see how you can kind of see through it? It's kind of peeking through. Really, really cool. In the past, if you wanted to get one of these transparent style gradients, you had to go into the Elements tab and search for a gradient that was already set that way. And then you could use that transparency. Now you can do it yourself. So it just really saves a lot of time. So that's how you're going to add your colors to your shapes. Next, you can add color gradients to Canva frames. Those are down here, right here where it says frames. And you have a whole bunch of shapes to choose from, literally just hundreds of shapes that you can choose from. And any of these shapes can have a photo, can have a video, can have a color, and now it can have a gradient. And you can pick any one of these style shapes that are right here. Maybe I'll choose that one right there. I'm going to go to my color tab. I'll just choose one of the pre-selected ones I've already done. And there you go. I've just added a gradient to that shape right there. So that makes it really easy and convenient. So some of the Canva shapes actually have multiple pieces to it in this frame section. So this one right here, this puzzle piece, it's actually got four sections to this frame. And I can apply a different color gradient combination to each one of those puzzle pieces. So I'm going to click on this first one. You can see how it's highlighting that piece right there. Click on this color. I'm just going to use one of Canva's preset colors right here. Now I'm going to take each one of these shapes and add the same color to it. You'll see why in a minute, just like that. And now I'm going to click on this first one. I'm going to change the direction and make it diagonal that way. And then I'm going to take this one. I'm going to make it diagonal the other way. So first I go diagonal, and then I just need to reverse the order of these two colors like that. And it made it diagonal in the other direction. And then this one, we're going to put it back to regular diagonal, and this one like that. It's kind of fun. You can really have a ball with a lot of these color combinations and make some just really neat looking backgrounds and stuff with this option. So then the next thing you can do with this is with a letter frame. You actually have letter frame options in Canva. Let me go back to frames and I'll show you. Letter. So you've got all these letters we can do right here. So watch what I'm going to do here. I'm going to do a letter S and a letter A and an L and an E. That one. All right. Let me just take all these guys, bring them down a little bit, and let me just arrange these real quick. Bring that there. Bring this here. Right about there. And then we're going to tell Canva to tidy this up for me, please. Tidy up. There we go. So now I can also add gradients right here within these letter frames, which make, you know, like a fun sale post. Click on the color. I'm just going to use Canva's preset color frames. So what I like about the preset colors that they have here, they've actually given you some color combinations that work really well together with other gradients. So let me show you. I'm going to use this first one. I'm going to pick this one right here. See, I've got like that purple to the green. Then for the second letter, I'm going to click this one. Kind of changes color combinations a little bit more. I'm going to click this next one and this next one. So that gave me just a really neat way to add these color gradients to these letter frames. And then I can make a fun sale post with that. And then the last way that you can add a color gradient is with what's called a grid. Those are right here. And a grid is simply a way to add additional photos in sort of like a collage fashion. And you've got multiple options here for adding all different shapes, sizes, rectangles, squares, lines. You can do all kinds of fun things with these color grids. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm just gonna grab this one. Let's grab this one. This one right here. Now, anytime you're using a grid, it's gonna automatically place a white border right here, a white space. We're gonna eliminate that. Click where it says spacing and bring it to zero because I want my colors to kind of all merge together. So once again, I've got four separate sections here that I can add a color gradient. Click on that first one, and I'm gonna add that one. Click on that one. Once again, I'm just gonna add the same color combination to each one of these, and then I'm gonna take it and I'm gonna make these diagonal because this one's kind of fun. Make this one diagonal, each one of these. Like that. Now you can leave it like that. Makes kind of a fun background, but just to add a little bit of interest, I'm gonna take this one right here and I'm going to switch the order around. So I'm gonna click on that gradient right there and I'm gonna move the pink over. See, so now I have my yellow and my yellow go right there. So that's just a fun way that you can add a little color combination to these grids right here. And then one more little bonus tip as far as adding the color gradients. I'm gonna go here up to the very top. This very first grid right here, that's just one piece. I'm gonna click on that. See how it took my whole canvas right there? I'm gonna drag this little handle. I'm gonna do something fun with this. I'm gonna bring it right about there. I'm gonna add a color option and I'm gonna add this rainbow gradient that I already did right here. Now, right now it's diagonal. I don't want it diagonal. I'm gonna change its direction right here so it's linear. There we go. So I've got that linear option. So now watch. I'm going to take this. I'm going to duplicate it and bring this to the bottom of my page. I'm going to duplicate it again. I'm going to rotate it 90 degrees like that. I'm going to bring it over here and I'm creating a gradient frame for one of my posts. I'm going to duplicate this one. I'm going to rotate it the other way, other 90 degrees right about there. And bring it like that. And there is a fun gradient color frame. Now you can take these and maybe fade it. You can see right here, it's going to that purple. So maybe I could repeat that purple color so that this color fades together. Right here in this corner, it's not quite so bad, but you can reverse those colors if you want to. Matter of fact, I'm gonna take this color right here and I can reverse those if I want to. So if I click right up here, right here, I can reverse the order of these colors so that it falls more in line with my position. Or I can just rotate this around like that. Either one of those methods will work as far as getting that color combination and those corners to line up. You basically just have to play around with a little bit to make sure that those corners line up in the color combinations that you want. And then you have a really fun gradient that you can use as a border. So you can see there's all different options that you can do here with these color gradients. Hop into Canva, start playing with some of these color combinations and make some really fun gradients for all of your designs. That's all for this Canva Caturday. See you next time.